Here the list of the major factors which proves the plastic has an important place in our daily lives. However, what we do after using the plastic articles? After we realize that they are no longer of any use to us, we throw them away, right? But have you ever wondered what happens after that? What is the journey of the plastic once it enters the garbage bin? You may wonder why it is so important to know about plastic, which is waste after thrown away. Just think for a moment. Plastic is the type of a solid waste. That means it will occupy space when we throw it away. And we can afford the consumption of space by waste materials at this point of growing population? Absolutely not. That makes us to find an alternative to just dumping of the plastic. Let us take a boat. What can be done with the plastic after we throw it away? One option is that we can burn it. What will that result in? By burning plastic, we could effectively get rid of them. This will make sure that no space will occupy, right? Wait, just think for a moment. Is it really advisable to burn plastic? We know the fact that plastic just melts on heating. It is not completely turns into ashes. What remains behind is simply an unusable form of molten plastic. And is there any other ill effect? Yes. Burning plastic leads to release various harmful fumes. The chemicals released can cause severe health issues in humans as well as other living organisms. So that means the option of burning plastic is completely ruled out from our list. What are the other options can we think of? Maybe we get try burying the plastic in soil. Can this be a good option? Maybe yes, because that would not lead to release of the harmful fumes and neither will occupy the space. So can we bury all the waste plastics that get generated? Wait a second. Will the microbes in the soil get affected if we dump plastic in their homes? Yes. The stress given to the naturally living organisms in the soil by plastic is quite significant. But why do they get stressed? Let me explain. We know that when organic matter gets into the soil, the microbes present will degrade. This is called the decomposition reaction. But the reaction is possible only when we have organic matter. And as far as we know, plastics are known were close to be an inorganic. Thus, the inorganic makes them unfit for decomposition. How do we address such substances scientifically? Well, those which can be degraded by the microorganisms are called biodegradable. Whereas materials like plastics which cannot be degraded called non-biodegradable. Thus, it is the non-biodegradable nature of the plastics that do not make them fit for burial. If we still bury them, then they will only occupy the space in the soil and it will also lead to soil pollution. And whatever, it will harm the natural microbes in the soil. So the option of burying plastic also get ruled out. So we cannot burn them or bury them. What option are we left with then? What can be done with the plastic waste generated? will the simplest, most convenient and environmentally friendly option is recycling. Yes, plastic has the property to melt when heated, and the molten plastic can be further molded into different forms. Thus, the plastic waste can be recycled to form new one for useful items. So, can we say we are sorted with plastic waste? Actually, not. Shouldn't the best option be to not generate plastic waste in the first place? Don't we have the substitute for the smaller plastic items that we use daily? For instance, the bags that we use shopping in the markets, the plastic ones was replaced with jute or any such natural material. This will help in lesser generation of plastic waste. It is our responsibility to keep the environment clean and safe for other organisms as well. And is there a better solution to this? Yes, we keep in mind the 4 R's. And what are the 4 R's, by the way? It simply stands for reduce, reuse, recycle and recover. It says that we should reduce the use of plastic in the first place. If we use it, then we should use repeatedly. That is, it has to be reused. Once it turns useless, we should recycle it. That means we should convert into similar or different products which is useful. And what recover means? There are many materials which are complex in nature. They cannot directly recycle. So we opt for recovering the energy stored in them. In such cases, we process the material in various stages to get the energy stored inside them. Following such rules can help us to keep the environment healthy. We must not forget that our beautiful planet is shared by many other living organisms too. Keeping the environment clean for ourselves as well as for other organisms is one of our most important responsibilities. Thank you. Thanks for watching the video.